بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته and welcome all viewers. Muslims. Nowadays, they're seen as strange. Things that they believe. Customs that they practice. The way that they dress. They're different compared to how you see other people living. Well, this being the case, I wanted to share three authentic narrations of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The first is where the Prophet, peace be upon him, told us Islam began as something strange and it will return to being strange as it began. So glad tidings to the strangers. So a few benefits I'd like to derive from this narration is the fact that number one, Islam began as something strange. So this strangeness that Muslims might feel is similar to what the Prophet, peace be upon him, and his companions, may Allah be pleased with them, also experienced. They were ridiculed, were persecuted, were seen as being backwards and strange. However, they knew they were upon the truth, and they would not let the misguidance of those around them, no matter how large their numbers were, lead them astray. And this is one of the many reasons why they were the best of generations. Another benefit to mention is that the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, he didn't say that Islam will return to being strange as it began. So in those times, make sure that you do whatever you can to fit in. Make sure you avoid being strange at all costs, that you just adopt whatever society throws at you. No, but rather he, sallallahu alayhi wasalam, said, so glad tidings to the strangers. So remember, if any of us feel like a stranger, we feel like the odd one out simply because we are practicing Islam, then remember, inshallah, you are from those who the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam gave glad tidings. The second narration I would like to mention is where the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, I wish I could meet my brothers. To which the companions, may Allah be pleased with them, replied, are we not your brothers? The Prophet, peace be upon him, answered, you are my companions, but my brothers are those who have faith in me, although they never saw me. Now this hadith shows us that not only do we strive to live like the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, not only do we love the Prophet, peace be upon him, but the Prophet also had love for us. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasalam knew that he would have followers from his nation that would come after him, after he died, yet they would believe in him. And you can see the love that he had for us, for those who came after him and have faith in him even though we never saw him. So may Allah keep us firm and may Allah make us of those who see the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the hereafter. Ameen. Now lastly, the third narration I would like to mention is where the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told his companions, there will come after you days of patience. For the one who holds on to what you're upon on that day is the reward of 50 of you. They asked, O Prophet of Allah, 50 from their own people? He sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, no, but rather from you. Meaning the reward of 50 from them, the companions, may Allah be pleased with them. And this hadith is an excellent reminder regarding the reality of this life. This is a test. We want to get rewarded by Allah in the hereafter. And because we are living in times of such trials and tribulations, Allah, the most generous, increases the reward for those who are upon what the Prophet ﷺ and his companions were upon. Those who hold tight to the Quran and Sunnah. Those who practice Islam according to the understanding of the Sahaba, the best generation. Even though it might be strange, even though it might be difficult, Allah is certainly the most generous and He gives the greatest rewards to whom He pleases. So may Allah make us of those that the Prophet ﷺ is referring to in these three narrations. May Allah keep us firm and give us a good end. Jazakum Allahu khairan. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.